Hello, Terraria Enthusiasts. My name is James, and welcome back to Chippy's Couch. Today, we are back once again for another round of the summoning adventure. So, hey, how you all been? Hopefully, while I was away, you all had a very merry Christmas. Now, I'm sure we're going to talk about Christmas a fair amount this episode, but what I want to know is, how was your Christmas day? How was your Christmas dinner? You could be as brutal as you want. And what was your favorite present? Which is one of my favorite questions to ask. I feel like it reveals a lot about you, depending on what you value. So for me, my favorite present was an espresso making kit that Courtney got me. And I also got a new clickety-clackety keyboard, which I'm very excited about. You'll probably hear it from now on, but I really like that. I've wanted a loud keyboard for like 7 years, but I've always gone, nah, like, I don't want the keyboard in the video. I want things to be perfect. And then now I embrace the fact that Chippy's couch is not really all that perfect regardless. So we now have a click, 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 and a clickety clackety clack, which is very nice. I don't know why I added so many clicks to the start of that. It was meant to be click, click, clack, 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 click. It's always weird when you have a break and come back. I feel like for me, I always muddle things up. And I'm already sensing that today, so we'll move swiftly on. But yeah, I hope it was a great Christmas. I really, really do. So what are we doing in today's episode? Well, we are doing the Aquatic Scourge, which has been driving me mad. I'm serious. I've wanted to know the answer to this question for ages. In the last episode, we died to the Aquatic Scourge in the last 2%, and I've thought about it since before Christmas. It winds me up. I need to know, was that the real fight, or was it just the first phase of the fight? Because if we died right at the end, that's not great. But it'll be fine. So let's buy a couple buffs. I already had some prepped before I took the break. So I don't actually remember which ones I need. I guess I need Endurance, Wrath. Has this one got Iron Skin? No? So we get Iron Skin as well? It's honestly really hard to remember. Because some of these Calamity ones will actually disable ones. So this one disables Regen and Life Force because it gives you a better one. So I guess I need Swiftness. Hunter. Why not take Hunter? All right. This all seems very good. Oh, yeah. Water Walking. I'll take a couple more of those. Okay, great. All right. Aquatic Scourge it is. And the best thing is we're actually going to streamline this quite a lot. Because I went and gathered some Starfish moments ago. So if we dump the starfish, I've already done it. I'm very organized. We can make, no, we can't. Wait, did I dump, where did I put the starfish? Or did I even, oh I needed shark fins. All right. Okay, well, that plans out of the window. Great, well done, James. First episode back and you've already goofed. Okay, so here's what we're doing. We're grabbing battle potions. What I was planning to do was to basically just cheat the system and spawn in Aquatic Scourge so that it's faster. This will no longer be the case. Yeah, we're just gonna manually walk there, slap on a battle potion, and hope for the best. But yeah, it was a really good break while I was away. It was very nice. I feel very satisfied. The best part about taking a break at Christmas is that it's only a couple of days, but it kind of feels like a couple of weeks. I feel like my body is not thanking me very much though. Since Christmas, all I've done is drink and eat rubbish. Like, it's bad, right? I've been enjoying my rum that I got gifted. I've been enjoying all the sweets I got gifted. So I think, and this is a bit of a cliche, we all know it, in Jan, it's time to change things up a little bit. The diet of a couple of months ago, that was amazing. Honestly, like, I did so much good for myself, but it's time to go back to the grind. There is also going to be a change with the channel come January as well, which I'm going to maybe set as my New Year's resolution. I kind of want to say I'm going to, but I'm feeling a little nervous about it, but I think I can do it. One of the biggest things that we had requested when I asked you guys about, like, what should we change on the channel is people said new games and new collaborations. So this is going to be a big thing in 2021. I really want to make sure that Chippy's couch stays fresh. It's kind of like if you have a couch in real life. You gotta slap a little bit of Febreze on that bad boy. Keep it smelling good. That's a lie. I don't think I've ever sprayed anything on my couch, but you get the metaphor. Yeah, so what I think we're gonna do is every Friday, we'll be playing a brand new game on the channel, and it won't be a let's playing. It will be like, hey, let's check out Noita, or let's do like a quick Stardew Valley mod, or I don't know. It's gonna be random, and you lot can recommend games, but there'll be like singular videos, kind of like a Call Me Kevin, or I don't know, like Nerd Cubed, something like that. Just because I talk about all these games all the time that I play, I never show them. And I think it winds people up as much as it kind of winds me up a little bit. So that's going to be a big thing in 2021, which I'm very excited about. Other than that, nothing's changing. I will do more collaborations though, but other than that, I feel like I love my channel. I really don't want anything to change. And I like that we're Terraria only, but I feel like it is time to keep it fresh. But also not disrupt the Let's Plays. So it's like, I like to think of it as, it's more videos for people that care to watch them, rather than being videos to diversify so more people watch. Do you know what I mean? Because ultimately, we're still a Let's Play channel for Terraria. Adding more games will never change that, which I like. Okay, so now I wait around for the Aquatic Scourge, which is going to be a nightmare, because I hate this, I find it very boring. But I'll speak to you guys in a couple of minutes. All right, there we go. There we go. Here it is. I'm not going to lie. We almost didn't do this fight because I was on my phone getting very distracted. Okay. Bam. Bam. Okay, let's go. Come on. Yeah, we're using the Gatlinator to get this started. Because last time, it bothered me so bad. I was like, come on, Summons. Do your job. All right, it's got a speedy charge. So when it does that, we're going to go. Come on, speed up then. Oh my god, there you go. I don't know what causes it to speed up. I don't know, because I was thinking about it when we did it last time. I didn't know if it was when it kind of locks onto you, or it's just a random attack. So we'll have to see. So this is my first time playing Terraria on the new click-clack keyboard. So I might actually be especially awful today, because I'm just kind of getting used to it. All I've used it for so far is typing out very long emails that didn't need to be overly long. Because I just really enjoy using it. So I'm like, all right, time to respond to that business email with a no, but I'll write them something very elegant just because I want to use it. Amazing. All right, so it's in terms of health, health is really low for us. So if we do get hit a couple more times, we have lost this fight, unfortunately. I'm just going to see what happens, though. You know, we might be all right. Oh, there you go. There you go. There's a little bit of adrenaline for your boy. Come on. Oh, my God. Remember, if we get hit... Oh, no, no, no. See, this is what happened to me last time. We got to literally this point. I just started to melt. Not uncommon, to say the least. All right. Is that the end of the fight? Oh, my God. Summons, please. All right. The Aquatic Scourge has been defeated. The Sulfuric Sky darkens. All right. Cool. There we go. There we go. Oh, that's cool. Perfection token. While this is in your inventory, your next weapon slash tool will be the best possible result. Consumes in the process. That is very nifty. That is really nifty. So now that we've done that, we've actually initiated, I believe, tier 2 of the Acid Rain event. Now, I don't know about you lot, but I really can't be bothered with it. Mainly because I don't know what there is from it yet. But if you can convince me that it has something amazing, we'll do it at the start of a next episode. Man, squeaky microphone. Listen to this, right? I need to change this. This is definitely something. Can you hear that? It's the squeak of a microphone arm. I reckon some WD-40 on that bad boy. And it might actually be alright. So where are we at then? We've got the mech bosses next. We could also do the pirate invasion. That would be good if we really wanted the little pirate staffs. But I feel like we don't particularly need that. Now I'm thinking there's probably something here that we might need. All right, let's do a mechanical boss. Let's do a mechanical boss because we have the free summon from the for Skeletron Prime. So why not give it a go? All right, what do we get? So we got the deep sea staff. Summons an aquatic star to fight for you. Right, I remember this. This is what we actually wanted to get from this event. So I'm super happy we got that straight away. Where are these little bad boys? All right, that's not the right one. Ice claspers. Okay, let's see what this is. Yeah, this is exactly what I thought it was. It's tiny little sea stars. We also got the bleached angling kit. Right click to open. So it came with crate potions and some angler pants. Thank you. Wow, the flying fish banner's legit. Look at that. I don't think I've ever had one before. Look at that. It looks more like a fish. That's so cool. We got the aquatic emblem. Most ocean enemies become friendly and provide water breathing. So this is all really good. This is stuff to use in the abyss. We've got some more stuff that we can use to... I didn't get any shark fins. Shark fins would have been ace. Okay, alright, cool. So we got a minute and a half then. A minute and a half, that's enough time to tell you about my stupid story, really. But it has a very cool ending, so it's not that stupid. Basically, this all goes back about 4 years ago. About 4 years ago, maybe more, my friend was doing an A-level in economics. I think that was it. Anyway, he told me about a thing called cryptocurrency, something which I didn't really know about. And I remember he showed me it, and he was like, oh, so you just buy it, and then you can use it for, like, stuff online. And I was like, so what can you buy online? He was like, I don't really know. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. Anyway, you can probably tell where this is going. Basically, I bought £10 of Bitcoin a couple of years ago. And I didn't really think about it ever again. I knew that it boomed up. I don't know when it boomed up, like 2 years ago, something like that. But it very quickly plateaued down. I just thought, well, I'm not really bothered about it. I didn't even have my bank account even set up with what I'd bought the Bitcoin on. And then I saw a tweet from KSI yesterday that was like, what's going on with Bitcoin? And I was like, well, what is going on with Bitcoin? And then I saw that my Bitcoin was worth a lot of money, a lot more than the £10. So I sold it and I got some nice headphones. So that's the moral of the story. This is going to be a terrible night, all right. That's obviously a free summon, so we'll take it. But which free summon is it? I don't really know. So yeah, that's the story of how I got into Bitcoin. Now, I care so little about cryptocurrency. I really don't care about it at all. You know, power to you if you're a big crypto guy or gal. I am not. I do not care about crypto at all. All right, I guess we just linger around now for a boss. Let's see what that's all about. This is the problem, isn't it? Where it's like, you get the free summon, but you have to linger around, so you kind of waste a little bit of time. Whereas I like to do a mechanical boss straight away. But I do have a very gut feeling that, you know, considering we have cryogen wings, and we have a summon that's probably way better than the summon you would normally get. Because you would normally do this with a spider staff, right? I reckon this is probably going to be no problem. The only difference is, this is Calamity, and Calamity does, of course, change... every boss when you play it in Revengeance mode. So we could get a version of Skeletron with seven arms. Or we could get the twins, but there's four of them. We could get the quadruplets. I never know... Alright, okay, so it is the twins. Alright, I was going to say I never know which one it is, but I've got a gut feeling it might be the twins. Alright, so what we do is we just let our summons do their thing. I feel like I need to zoom out more, but I actually can't. It's really weird because people always ask me, how do I zoom out so much? I don't use a mod or anything. I just play with a, you know, I don't know. It's funny because I have a 4K monitor, but I play in 1080p for my Terraria recordings. Because 4K Terraria looks a little strange. It's hard to explain. It's also hard to render. I don't know where I was going with that, but yeah, I don't use a mod or anything to zoom out a lot. But I feel like I'm lacking a mod right now. I need to zoom out even more. It's really odd. So I guess for now, I don't really have a super strong way of balancing these fights out. Obviously, as you know, I would try and balance the two out so that we're a little bit more even. But I haven't really got that opportunity. Oh, one thing I would love a Rod of Discord right now. Oh my god. Every time I see a fight like this, I'm just like, the Rod of Discord would make such a difference. Alright, there you go. There's our second adrenaline. I did not realize that I'd gotten a little bit better at the twins. I feel like Featherworthy unlocked something in my brain because you play the game in such a different way. You know, AI and stuff becomes menial. I don't know, it's really odd. That's why I'm excited to do the hardcore series that we're doing right now. God, if I beat that series, I'm going hardcore Featherworthy. I'm just going to do it. I'm going to go all the way. But we're only into hard mode in the hardcore series, so that's going to be hard. Oh, I can't wait to talk about the troll in the comments in the next episode of Hardcore. Wow, that's going to be so good. If you lot haven't seen, we trolled the comments with the last episode of Hardcore, and it was wild. It was probably the most successful troll we've ever done, and it was amazing. It was really, really funny, and I howled about it for ages. Okay. Ooh, so I'm not doing very well now. Do you remember how, like, moments ago I was bigging myself up? I was talking about how things are golden. I don't think they're really golden anymore. Now, this is super hard, this part. I'm hoping that my my little icicles are going to do a bit more damage. I feel like my movement is a little bit better than it was. Oh, God. Oh, no. Than it was 2 seconds ago, but still not really. Okay, so that's going to be one dead. Oh, it's the worst one for me is dead. Oh, that's great. I thought what was going to die was... oh, God. So, oh, no, no, no. Oh, there's the Revengeance mode twist, as always. Had to happen. I might actually need a Rod of Discord, come to think of it. I might need to go get one. Okay, forget about what I was saying moments ago. I was about to say... Oh, I don't know what I was about to say. Forgive me. I've gone smooth brain. It did not take long. All right, that way. I really don't know how I'm meant to be moving. And also, can we just appreciate my summons are doing absolutely nothing? I've just tried to reshift their focus, so I think it might be working a little bit better. Oh, God, it's so bad. It's so hard. Christ. It's like you've got to avoid two things. You've got to avoid the shadow balls, but... Oh, my God, Christ. The die trader, no. You will be missed. No, we definitely lose 4 health, 5 health. All right. How much longer can we keep this up? I don't think much longer at all. Am I anywhere close? No, I'm 40 seconds away from a heal. Yeah, we've definitely lost. It's all right, rip. That's okay. We'll get it tomorrow, I believe. Maybe we might have to do Skeletron Prime first. No. Oh. Oh. No. Yeah, that was brutal. A little part of me did believe I might survive. When I did like 10 seconds of being alive, I thought, this is good. I feel this. I didn't get to talk about Pixar. I'm going to talk about Pixar tomorrow. Somebody remind me if I forget. I went on a Pixar binge and watched like 4 Pixar movies that I hadn't seen. Wow. I was really off of Pixar's work and now I'm a big fan. I'm a Pixar-lite. Is that what they call them? I don't know. Right, hope you had a great day watching this. I'm like, I've made your day. Very vain of you, James. But I hope you enjoyed watching. Thank you so much for coming back after a break. I'm always surprised people do, so it's lovely. Like I said, I hope you had a good Christmas. Please do write me a comment down below. I want to know the answer to those 3 questions. How's the day? How's the dinner? What's your favorite present? Right, thank you to our channel members, as always. That is about it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.